The problem is find the potential drop across 1 ohm, 3 ohm, 4 ohm by using the VDI. Find the current through 1 ohm, 3 ohm, 12 ohm by using the CDR. Now we have this circuit. So in this circuit, the potential drop of the battery is 8 volt, and we have few resistors which are connected in series and in parallel. So let's give the name to the branches A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Now, to find the potential drop, across 1 ohm. So we write the formula for this, the potential drop across 1 ohm. So here it is 1 ohm and the total resistance of the circuit and multiply by the source voltage. So here we have the source voltage 8 volt and 1 ohm also we have the resistor. But now we have to find the value of this RT. So this circuit is basically a series circuit, but it is also some resistors are also connected in parallel. So here we have to find the resistance between A and B from here to here, this one, and this is 1 ohm, and from here to here, so this and this is 4 ohm and this is 2 ohm. So it has 4 parts. To find the total resistance, okay, so what we have to do, we have to find the resistance of this, it is 1 ohm, it is given, and we have to compute the resistance in this circle, so in this circle, and the resistance of this and the resistance of this, and they will be in the series. So first we calculate the resistance of the parallel combination. So this is A. So first we will work here. Now the resistance in this circle, basically this is the combination of the series and the parallel. So if I start from this 6 ohm and this 12 ohm, they are in parallel. So if I find the resistance of this is 1 over 3 and this is 1 over 6, so this is equal to, this is 4 ohm, and let us say this is RA. Now we got the total resistance of this parallel combination, the 6 ohm and the 12 ohm. Now this 2 ohm is with the series with this 4 ohm resistor. Now if I say this is RB, and the RB is, this is 4 ohm and plus this is 2 ohm. So this is, here it is 6 ohm now. And the resistance from C to E, the resistance from C to E is parallel with B to F. So they are parallel. Now if I say this is RC, so the RC is 1 over 6 and this is 1 over 3, so this is equal to 2 ohm. So the resistance of this circle is 2 ohm. The value of the RC is coming 2 ohm. So this 2 ohm is from here to here. The total resistance of this circle is, now it is 2 ohm. So this is 2 ohm. Now we have to find the total resistance. So the total resistance is 1 ohm and it is 2 ohm plus 4 ohm and this is 2 ohm. So the total resistance is coming 9 ohm. The total resistance of the whole circuit. Now, by using the Ohm's law, we can find the current passing in this circuit. Simple. So the Ohm's law, by using the Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. So the current passing, the total current passing here, this is V over RG, and the potential, the source voltage is 8 volt, and the total resistance is 9. So after the calculation, it will come 0.88 ampere. So this is the current passing in the circuit. So now this 0.8 ampere current is coming from here. So this current, this is the IT, which is coming from the battery, 0.88 ampere. So this 0.88 ampere current passing from here. And when this current is coming at this node, so this current is dividing in many parts. So first the current is coming here. Okay, so this 0.88 current, some part is coming in this branch and some part is coming in this branch. So now this branch is further dividing into another branches. So they are in parallel. So again this current will divide. And here when this current is coming out, so this is again 0.88 ampere. Now the current is coming here and it is coming here, and from the 2 ohm resistor the same current is passing, that is 0.88 ampere. Now we have to find the voltage, we have to use the VDR rule, and by using the VDR rule we have to find the voltage across 1 ohm resistor. So this is R1 over RT. So the R1 is here 1 ohm and the 2, and here RT. So this is RT and multiply by the source voltage. So this is equal to 1 ohm and the RT is 9 and this is multiplied by 8. So this is equal to 0.88 volt. So this is the voltage across the 1 ohm resistor. Now there is a voltage, that is the voltage across 3 ohm. Actually this is little bit, it is a tricky, the voltage across 3 ohm. So here in the formula it comes R1. So it comes here, it comes R1 and the R total. So this comes R1 and here this is R total and multiply by the source voltage. So the tricky thing is here. So basically this, there is no one resistor. Basically across the 3 ohm there are another resistors also connected, so we have to take into account other resistor also. So see, this is 3 ohm here, but with this 3 ohm this much combination is in parallel, so we have to here, we cannot take here, we cannot take this 3 ohm, this is wrong, we cannot take here 3 ohm here. So we have to take the resistance between this point and this point. What is the total resistance between these two points, that we have to take, not the 3 ohm. If only 3 ohm is there, then we have to take 3 ohm. Otherwise, if another resistors are in parallel with the 3 ohm or the combination of the parallel and the series, then we have to take the total. Now here, this is the R1 is not merely, it is 3 ohm. So the R1 is a resistance between the resistance between this point and this point, which is equal to 2 ohm. So here this is 2 ohm and the total is, it is 9 ohm and multiply by the source voltage. So now the question here is, why we are not taking here 3 ohm? Because there is no only 3 ohm here, because this resistor and this resistor, they are in parallel, then they are in series here, and then this arm is with parallel with this one. So we have to take the resistance of the branch, we have to take the resistance of the branch, not only that resistance. So this, at this point you have to be very careful by taking the value of the resistance. So here it will be, so when if I calculate, so this is 2 ohm and here it is 9 ohm and the voltage is 0 point, the voltage is 8 ohm. So this is the voltage is 8 volt. So 8 I am writing here. So the voltage across, if I calculate this one, so this is 1.77 volt. Now the voltage across 4 ohm. So if you see here, like this is R1. Okay, so R1 value here we have to write, and this is R total, and this is the source voltage. Now here I will take only 4 ohm. Okay, because here there is no resistor with this 4 ohm, there is no resistor here. So that's why I will not take any other resistor with the 4 ohm, only 4 ohm. So here this is 4 ohm, and this is 9 ohm, and this is 8 voltage, and this is equal to 3.55 volt. Now we have to find the current passing through 1 ohm. So the current passing through 1 ohm, so already we have calculated by using the Ohm's law. So this is 0.88 ampere, it is coming. Now this 0.88 ampere, it is passing from here. Now, so now we have to find that by using the CDF formula, the current passing through 3 ohm. So the formula is, this is R total and this is R1. R1 is a resistance, here it is 3 ohm, and multiply by IT. So now in here, up to this node, this current is coming 0.88. when this 0.88 current is coming at this node, so some amount of the current is passing from here, from 3 ohm, and the remaining current is passing from here, from this branch CE. And in this, because I am applying the CDR rule here in this parallel composition, so here I am applying the CDR rule. So here I am applying the CDR rule. So in this formula, I will take the total of this circuit. So now here R total is, this is 2 ohm, and the R1 is, it is 3 ohm, and multiply by, this is 0.88, and this is equal to 0.58 ampere. Now we have to find the current passing through 12 ohm. So the formula is, this is R total of the parallel circuit, and this is R1. R1 means where the current is passing. So, and it is a total, and this is the total current. This is the total current which is passing in the parallel circuit. So here the parallel circuit is, the parallel circuit here, it is this one. So we have to apply the CDR here in the 6 ohm and the 12 ohm. So here the total, so the total of the parallel 6 ohm and the 12 ohm, so this is equal to 4 ohm. So here we have to take the 4 ohm and IT. So what is the total current for this? How much current is passing from, how much current is passing from CE? The current passing from CE. So we can use the formula. See, from the node, before the node B, from this node, the current is coming 0.88, and from the 3 ohm resistor, the current is passing 0.58. So subtract from here, so you will get 0.3 ampere. So now in this parallel composition, the total current is passing 0.3 ampere. Now go back to the, okay, now go back to this equation, the current passing through 12 ohm. So the total here, it is 4 ohm, and this is 12 ohm here, and the current passing in the parallel circuit, the parallel of 6 and 12 ohm. And so this is 0.3, and after the calculation, it will come 0.1 ampere. Thanks for the listening.